Good morning friends, welcome you all on my channel Biomanic. Friends, in the previous lectures we have discussed about different subtopics in the photosynthesis. Today a very important topic regarding all types of examinations, be it board, be it its NEET examination, the C3 cycle. Or we are starting from today the dark phase of photosynthesis, or the dark reactions of the photosynthesis. Now coming to the topic, C3 cycle, what exactly the C3 cycle is? See friends, when we talk about the photosynthetic plants, these photosynthetic plants, they take CO2 in the presence of water, in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, and form what? Glucose plus oxygen plus water, what we have studied till yet. Now how this glucose is formed? In the last lecture we have discussed about the electrochemical gradient shunt of protons, that proton pump, the chemoosmosis. So the protons which are delivered to the stroma will be captured by the electron and the proton carriers, mean the assimilatory powers, okay, and the reducing power too. The reducing power is NADPH and the assimilatory power is ATP plus NADPH, okay. Now what are the exactly requirements of this C3 cycle and what exactly the C3 cycle is? See, the very first point is what exactly the C3 cycle is. Why it is known as C3 cycle? Isko C3 cycle kyun kehte hain? In this cycle, first of all I would like to tell you, this cycle was discovered by Calvin Benson in the year 1955, and later on he was awarded with a Nobel Prize also for the same. So the Calvin Benson cycle, or the Calvin cycle, or we can also say isko pentose phosphate pathway bhi kehte hain, also known as pentose phosphate pathway, also known as photosynthetic carbon reduction cycle, PCR. So all these names they get you confused. Okay, C3 cycle, PPP, pentose phosphate pathway, and PCR, photosynthetic carbon reduction. Okay, now this C3 cycle is mean the main point which you have to remember, that why it is known as C3 cycle, because the first stable compound which is formed during the reaction is a 3-carbon compound, a 3-carbon compound known as 3-phosphoglyceric acid. So the first point what you have to remember from the examination point of view, that why it is known as C3 cycle, because the first stable compound which is formed is C3, mean 3-carbon compound, that is phosphoglyceric acid. In this reaction we are having different types of compounds having different carbon moieties, carbon atoms, but the first stable compound is what? A 3-carbon compound, that is phosphoglyceric acid. Now what is the primary acceptor of CO2 in this cycle? Very common question. So here we are having a 5-carbon molecule known as ribulose. It is known as ribulose. Ribulose is a isomer of ribose, 5-carbon sugar. Ribulose jo hai wo ribose ka isomer hai, 5-carbon ki sugar hai. To ribulose, bisphosphate ya biphosphate kuch bhi bol sakte hain isko. Ribulose, bisphosphate ya ribulose biphosphate. Okay. So this is ribulose biphosphate, mean a 5-carbon compound having 2 phosphate group attached on 1st carbon and 5th carbon, mean like that, 1 2 3 4 5. So this is phosphate and this is phosphate. So this is ribulose bisphosphate or ribulose biphosphate. Okay, now this RuBP is a 5-carbon molecule. So this RuBP combines with CO2 of atmosphere, 5-carbon plus 1-carbon, in the presence of the most abundant enzyme of this word. It is written as R-U. U B I S C O, like this. So this RUBP, which is a 5-carbon compound, it assimilates one molecule of CO2 in the presence of most abundant enzyme of the world, of the universe, that is Rubisco. Ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate carboxylase oxygenase. इसकी पूरी फुल फॉर्म क्या है? रिबुलोज 1,5 बाईफॉस्फेट. बस हमें यहाँ ये बता दिया कि 1,5 बाईफॉस्फेट है. तो रिबुलोज 1,5 बाईफॉस्फेट या बिसफॉस्फेट कार्बोक्सिलेज ऑक्सीजनेज. यहाँ पर भी हम इसको बोल सकते हैं रिबुलोज 1,5 बिसफॉस्फेट. ठीक है ना? सो इसको मैं लिख भी दे रहा हूँ, और रिबुलोज 1,5 बिसफॉस्फेट. So we are having 5 carbon plus 1 carbon to form a 6 carbon compound, which is an unstable compound, and this 6 carbon unstable compound further degrades into stable 3 carbon compound. Okay, so we are having 1 mole of RUBP combining with 1 mole of CO2 to form what? 1 mole of 2-carboxy, 3-keto, 1,5 bisphosphoribitol. Okay, so this is the very first reaction in which the RUBP getting carboxylated, it is adding with CO2 to form 1 mole of 2-carboxy, 3-keto, 1,5 bisphosphoribitol, which is unstable compound, gives 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Here we are having 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Okay friends, so this is the first stable compound, PGA, 3-PGA, which is formed in the very first step of Calvin cycle, Calvin-Benson cycle, okay, also known as C3 cycle. So the very first step is carboxylation, and we have completed the step of carboxylation. So this is carboxylation. RUBP 5 carbon combines with 1 carbon CO2 in the presence of Rubisco enzyme to form 1 mole 3-carboxy 3-keto to 1,5 bisphosphoribitol, which is further decomposed as it is thermally unstable, actually unstable, okay, to form what? 3-phosphoglyceric acid. So this is the first stable product. Now this first stable product, 3-phosphoglyceric acid, is to be further reduced. So the second step is reduction. And the third step is regeneration of RUBP. RUBP. So these are the three steps. Okay friends, let's begin with the... This is in the carboxylation step we have discussed. Carboxylation. Okay, what happened? Ribulose biphosphate, these are 2-phosphate molecules. Okay, they combine with atmospheric CO2. Okay, 1 mole, 5 carbon. The process is carboxylation. CO2 is getting in, okay, to form what? 3-phosphoglyceric acid. We are having 2 moles over here. It's a 3-carbon compound. Okay, now this 3-phosphoglyceric acid is further phosphorylated. Phosphorylated means ATP is converted to ADP, And the inorganic phosphate which is delivered is being attached by this molecule on its first position. Okay, so we are having here 1,3 biphosphoglyceric acid. So 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid or diphosphoglyceric acid. 1,3 diphosphoglyceric acid. Okay, so we are having 2 moles here, so we will be getting 2 moles also here. Okay, now 2 ATP to form 2 ADP. Okay, now this 1,3 diphosphoglyceric acid is phosphorylated, so this is basically the phosphorylation step. Okay, now coming to the next, this molecule is further reduced, the next step is reduction. Okay, it is further reduced, reduction. Now reduction takes place in the presence of dehydrogenase enzyme. That is, we are having what? NADP to give rise NADPH plus H plus. Okay, so this NADPH plus H plus gives the protons to get itself oxidized, and these protons are taken by these phosphoglyceric acid molecules to get reduced. Now they are converted into phosphoglyceraldehyde. Now 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde means 1 phosphate is also eliminated. So from the first position, the phosphate is also eliminated. If we are having 2 moles, then 2 phosphates are eliminated. Okay, so the step is the 1,3 biphosphoglyceric acid undergoes dephosphorylation. In the presence of dephosphorylation, the phosphate group is eliminated and it has also undergone reduction. So NADPH plus H plus removes the proton of itself to get itself oxidized and to reduce phosphoglyceric acid molecule to form 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Now this 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, it is a connecting junction, it is a connecting point between photosynthesis and respiration. Means this is a common substrate which is followed by respiration as well as photosynthesis, as we have studied. Fructose 1,6 by bisphosphate is further converted into a triose compound. Triose means 3 carbon compound, that is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is further converted to dihydroxyacetone phosphate, so DIHAP. Okay, so they were both isomers, so the same step is being shown by this molecule here also. As we have, this is 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, or we can also write as 3G3P, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, no worries. Okay, so this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate enters in the formation of what? Glucose. In respiration, we are having glucose as a substrate and the pyruvic acid is the main product. Here we are having 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde as a substrate and we are having glucose as the main product. Okay, so the process is glycotic reversal. अब ये जो G3P बना है glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, ये क्या करेगा? Glycotic reversal करेगा. Glycotic reversal से ये glucose बनाएगा, ठीक है ना? और the steps are exactly the reverse what we have studied in oxidation, what we have studied in glycolysis. Okay, now this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, 3 phosphoglyceraldehyde or glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, we are having 2 moles, exactly 2 moles. It's a 3 carbon compound. Now out of this 3 carbon, 1 carbon we can say one carbon is transferred for the formation of glucose. Okay, like we are having, it's 2 mole. So 3 carbon in 2 moles, mean total we are having 12 carbon. So from those 12 carbons, 2 carbons are transferred to the glycolytic reversal process, and the 10 carbon, they are regenerated to form what? RUBP. So in 2 mole mein se hame 2 mole kya 5 carbon compound chahiye. तो 2 मोल 5 कार्बन कंपाउंड होता है, टोटल कार्बन कितने होने चाहिए 10. लेकिन यहां पर कितने कार्बन है हमारे पास, 3 × 2 दैट इज 6. तो 6 कार्बन में से हमें 2 कार्बन हटाने हैं. तो ये 2 कार्बन कैसे हटेंगे, ये 2 कार्बन ग्लाइकोटिक रिवर्सल में चले गए. ओके, गेटिंग माई पॉइंट. सो नाउ द प्रोसेस इज रीजनरेशन ऑफ RUBP. अगेन द ATP इज ट्रांसफर्ड और ATP इज कन्वर्टेड टू ATP. हियर वी आर हैविंग 1 ATP इंटू 1 ATP. ठीक है ना. तो कहने का मतलब ये जो 2 मोल्स थे, इन 2 मोल्स में से एक हमारा कहाँ चला गया, ग्लाइकोटिक रिवर्सल में चला गया, और एक हमारा कहाँ चला गया, RUBP के रीजनरेशन में चला गया. ठीक है ना, आपको बात समझ में आ रही फ्रेंड्स. ठीक है, चलिए अब इसकी बायो एनर्जेटिक समझ लेते हैं. दैट अगर हमें ग्लूकोज जो कि 6 कार्बन का है, मीन ग्लूकोज इज ऑफ 6 कार्बन, C6H12O6, एंड इफ वी वॉन्ट टू फॉर्म दिस ग्लूकोज C6H12O6, मीन वी आर हैविंग 1 कार्बन हेयर ओनली, we need 6 more carbons. We need 6 more carbons. So for the formation of glucose, we require 6 moles of CO2 to combine with 6 moles of RUBP. Okay, so into 6, total carbon 30. Okay, now after carboxylation process, we are having 12 moles of PGA, that is 18 carbon. Okay, now into 6, 12 ATP, they are forming 12 ADP. Okay, means same 12 moles of bisphosphoglycerate acid, then into 6, 12 moles of NADP plus to form 12 moles of NADPH plus H plus, and also 12 moles of inorganic phosphate. Now it is further converted to, it is reduced to form G3P glyceryl-3 phosphate into 6. But 12 moles we are having, 12 moles, 2 moles are gone for the glycolytic reversal. Okay, 5 moles are regenerated. So this is 5 moles are regenerated. Okay, so the total carbon is 6 × 12, 12 × 3 = 36. 36 minus 6 carbon of the glucose, we will be getting 30 carbons again of RUBP. So this is what called the bioenergetics of Kelvin cycle. ठीक है ना, पर यहां पे टोटल कितने कार्बन हो रहे हैं, 6 × 12, 12 × 3 = 36. 36 कार्बन हो रहे हैं, 36 कार्बन से हमने एक ग्लूकोज के मॉलिक्यूल को माइनस कर दिया, तो 6 कार्बन हमारे चले गए. तो अब हमें वापस से हमारे पास कितने कार्बन होने चाहिए, 30 कार्बन होने चाहिए. ठीक है, तो अब इसको भी तो मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे इंटू सिक्स, और 6 इनऑर्गेनिक फॉस्फेट और निकलेंगे, 6 IP. ठीक है, तो दिस इज वॉट द ओवरऑल रिएक्शन ऑफ कैल्विन, मीन द कैल्विन बेंजीन साइकिल. ओके, मीन द ओवरऑल रिएक्शन कैन बी रिटन एज CO2 plus 6 RUBP plus 6 CO2 plus 6 RUBP plus 18 ATP, okay, give rise to plus 12 NADP plus H plus, give rise to C6H12O6 plus 18 ADP plus 18 inorganic phosphate plus 12 NADP plus. So this is the overall reaction of Kelvin cycle. Okay friends, we will move to the further topics in the next video. So I will be talking about C4 cycle, Heijn-Schenck pathway in the next video. Till then, bye bye, thank you.